So welcome back, everyone. It is Francesco here. Today we're diving into Meister Note. Now, it's weird to say that because they have Meister Task, Mind Meister. Now they have Meister Note. We'll be reviewing the new note-taking application from this company, Meister, and sharing about sort of team aspects and personal aspects of how you can use it. It's our first time trying it out, but we're going to give you all that you need to know about this application. Before we begin, guys, we have a brand new Skillshare class all about my own personal productivity workflows. I'm going to be mentioning how I use Task, Calendar, and Notes inside of one course. It's on Skillshare. You can get it free in the link in the description. It's about 47 minutes long, and I think you'll really enjoy it. So let's get all signed up for an account. Okay, so after a fairly easy sign up, I'm now into Meister Note, and as you can see, very much Notion-esque in its design. If I, for example, wanted to create a new page or new note, I can press the plus button, and as you can see here, a new note has been created. Let's say I wanted to sort of start organizing my meeting for this afternoon, maybe with Bob, and I can add a cover, and as you can see, they bring in from Unsplash and also some of their own. You've also got an icon and they've got a few custom made ones. They've got more from here. They all look sort of like icon findery, which is good enough for sort of having icon set up. And as you can see here, there's a slash command to get you started. So nothing you wouldn't expect to see inside a Notion, with more of a fluffy design, a little bit nicer in my opinion. Maybe it's the font, maybe it's just the rounded edges, but just slightly nicer in my opinion. However, they don't have what you'd expect inside of this application. They say they have 15 content blocks, but obviously if you compare it to Notion, Notion has a considerable amount more, not just with the API, but also with the fact that they've got databases. Inside of this, the blocks, they tend to have a similar sort of structure. So for example, these three blocks would be condensed into one block in Notion. And as you can imagine, they're three blocks. So they're the same thing, just with different colors and different icons. So you can see what I mean. They've sort of expanded their blocks as much as they possibly can. And it's actually a little bit easier to understand them than, say, you would inside of Notion. In Notion, you do require a slight little bit more education when it comes to utilizing the tool and customizing it further. So the real sort of integrations that make this application different is the Meister Task integration and the Mind Map integration. So let's show you how that works. So if I wanted to create a new task, I could, for example, add like follow up Bob as a task, and I can add it to a project that I've got in here. And I can add it in the stage of which it's in and assign it to a person. And as you can see, the task actually appears in the top right corner. And if I were to click on it here, it would take me directly to Meister Task. And I can add all of the relevant details. In this case, add more checklist items, add attachments, etc., etc., and obviously go a step further. However, it won't allow me to do that inside of this. It's more of a preview window, which is nice in a way, but not necessarily ideal if you're trying to sort of bring together everything and sort of do stuff all in one app. However, you do have this lovely right-hand panel that allows you to see all your tasks in one view, which is super nice. So when it comes to replicating a note that could turn into a meeting template, if I were to go to a note and press right-hand side, I can save it as a template and I can include things like subnotes, but a new template over here is created. So nothing that you wouldn't expect, and you can create a new note from the template here. You can move the template, obviously up here. You can, in the pro plan, create unlimited templates, which means you get things like larger attachments, workspace sharing, unlimited workspaces, bulk note comp duplication. Let's take a look at the pricing plans for this current experience. Okay, so I wasn't sure what the pricing plans were, but as you can see, for basic, which is free, you get up to five workspaces, a number of notes unlimited, number of content blocks, which is good, 20 meg per file, which is fairly reasonable, and also 7 days of version history. So in terms of the features, you don't get the predefined templates in this one. I'm not sure they've updated that, but you do get things like spell check, presentation mode, note printing, integrations, but you don't get things like admin accounts and the full note covers, note duplications, and custom template. However, it's a fairly good free plan. I don't really see a huge problem with it. So as you can imagine, that's fairly reasonable. They've got a pro plan, which really boosts you in terms of the version history, gives you unlimited workspaces, and also really does give you more multiple team members, real-time collaboration, and also assumingly you'd have improved sort of templates here. You can get better note duplication at Unsplash, but for $5.99 a month, that's fairly reasonable. I wouldn't say that's incredible. Maybe they should down their free plan a little bit because it's not that much difference, but obviously still early days for this application. So one thing that's quite nice is you can create workspaces from here and you can create workspace groups. I quite like this sort of like panel view that you get. You can also change it to like sort of this sort of vision view. And as you can see here, I can go back in anytime I want to get things going. I can see version history over here, information, and I can even duplicate the note and save it. Presentation mode is here. This would look really nice and zoomed in on presentation mode. I'd say there's really not too much hideously different from Notion. Notion, I think, packs way more in against something like this. Still early days for this application. Sort of like the fact that you can connect it to MeisterTask, but there's not really too much detail in terms of how much you can do inside of MeisterNote. You can obviously attach, you can create mind maps as well, but I can assume that's just an embedding inside of it, but it's not really that impressive in terms of that. One thing I like is the design. I really like the fact that you can create templates straight away. I like this right-hand panel with the tasks, but aside from that, I'm sort of glad it's free. You can see that you can switch between these here, but at the moment, I don't necessarily see this being a Notion competitor directly. So folks, that was my opinions on MeisterNote. Let me know what you think of the application and feel free to share it in the comments below.